This week on NBA Jam, we'll profile Orlando's Penny Hardaway, and we'll look back at the flight of Air Jordan.
Up on the goes baseline, reverses. Oh, yes! Amazing!
We'll also take you to Houston, Texas for a tour with the Rockets' Matt Bullard.
Have a good old time.
As we take a look back at the career of Bulls great Michael Jordan. He would grow up to become the most recognizable athlete in the world. But Michael Jordan first gained fame with his last second heroics in 1982. His shot clinched the national title for the University of North Carolina. Michael went on to win an Olympic gold medal before entering the NBA in 1984 with the Chicago Bulls.
It was a very opportune time for me to come into the league.
At the time, the league's household names were Magic and Bird, but Michael would usher in the age of Air Jordan.
Magic Johnson and Larry Bird started it all. It was the versatility that they brought to the game of basketball. I expanded it off the ground, in a sense.
Jordan, oh, balls it up! Leaves the middle open. Jordan, what a move!
Look at the air, look at the hang time, look at the flying motion.
Early in my career, I was never really a vocal leader. I didn't feel comfortable in doing so. But I think that the way that I spoke up in terms of leadership is my play.
His play spoke for itself, as he did things the league had never seen before. Jordan could score in bunches, but was criticized for not leading the Bulls to a title. For years, they stumbled in the playoffs, losing to the Detroit Pistons.
I felt there was a lesson being learned with a team that was a little bit ahead of us. They were better than we were, and more experienced. I felt it was very disappointing each and every time that we ended up getting to this hurdle and couldn't get over it.
Finally, in 1991, they overcame their nemesis, sweeping the Pistons in the Eastern Conference Finals. The Bulls went on to beat the Lakers for their first NBA title, and Michael soared to a new level, eclipsing Magic as the greatest player in the game.
Everybody knew that it was coming. It's just when. When was he going to be ready to receive it and take it? And boy, did he receive it and take it.
I feel good.
The Bulls went on to win 5 championships in 7 years, becoming the NBA's newest dynasty. And the cornerstone was Jordan. He was not only the league's most talented player, but also one of the most competitive. And his perseverance, hard work, and desire would set an example for the rest of the team to follow.
If you need something done, I do it. You know, defense.
Oh, what a play by Michael!
Passing.
Michael in transition.
Scoring.
Superman's back in the building! Superman is back in the building!
That was a challenge that I took. Now, I think a lot of that has to do with my personality as well.
His personality helped him achieve celebrity status that reached far beyond the basketball court. And as Michael's fame hit phenomenal heights all over the world, he was also helping to raise the global popularity of the game itself.
What changed the game to some extent, and what really propelled me to where the kids could relate with me, was the marketing of an athlete.
Something like a phenomenon. Something like a phenomenon. Something like a phenomenon. Something like a phenomenon.
It's the easiest job in America, where you can go out and you can play for 2 hours and then gain all the notoriety and respect of millions.
Comes into Jordan. Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good! The Bulls win it! They win it!
You know, I'm just a normal guy. I've just been lucky thus far.
Against Russell, Michael hangs, fires, scores!
I'm very appreciative of an opportunity to see the best, play against the best, and hopefully evolve to be one of the best.
On opening weekend, Michael and the Bulls raised their championship banner. You'll see that and some other stories from around the league in Total NBA.
That's
Miami Heat center Alonzo Mourning had a chance to play the role of fashion model for a day. Joe was the focus of a photo shoot for a magazine.
It's fun, and it also helps promote the NBA.
He has like a total fallback career if basketball doesn't work out for him.
Nah, I couldn't see myself being a model.
Yeah. Cool.
Can everyone say that? Fast break for eating?
Kids in Atlanta had a special visitor to their school, the Hawks' Christian Leitner. He was there to spread a message about how much fun it can be to read.
We're trying to teach them and point out that it's very important to learn how to read and to start reading at a very young age.
When I was your age and your size, I went to school so I can learn how to read. You have to learn how to read.
Three-point play is reading is fun and entertaining, reading is educational, and reading is part of your everyday life.
The Bulls got a big surprise in their opening game of the season. Led by head coach Rick Pitino, the new-look Boston Celtics defeated Chicago behind a big game from Antoine Walker.
Baseline. Count it! He'll get to the line.
The following night, however, the Bulls celebrated their fifth NBA title as they raised the championship banner and received their championship rings.
Well, we're a five-time champion going for six. If we never win another one, we're certainly going to win the sixth one.
Throughout opening weekend, the NBA season got off to a flying start.
Inside. Oh, baby, what a play!
Thomas finds his way to the goal and slams for two.
The opener of the season. Allen slams for two. Quite a move by Ray Allen.
Gugliotta. Behind the back to Garnett.
Oh! And the big ticket just punched one home.
Hardaway bringing it up. Double team. Length of the floor, running jumper.
That's it for total NBA. But stick around, we'll keep on jamming right after this. Starring in NBA shorts this week, a player whose game is truly magical. He's Orlando's all-star guard, Penny Hardaway.
Hi, I'm Penny Hardaway, and I play point guard for the Orlando Magic.
Here we go!
Penny on the run.
Here we go!
Oh,
here we go.
What a shot!
Whoa, ho, 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 ho.
Second, third grade, when I first even touched the basketball, my grandmother had bought me a basketball, and from that time on, man, the basketball, really, I knew we had to be best friends if I wanted it to work for me and to be successful in it.
Oh, look at Penny spin and hit like a tornado.
I think once the ball is in my hands that, you know, I can either push the button to go or push the button to slow down. And, you know, most of the time it's always on the go.
Hardaway one on two behind the back. Splits through. Oh, what a pass to Anderson. Oh, my. Hardaway sensationally placed and a great reaction by Penny.
Just to have this ball in your hands all the time, like you said, growing up with it and knowing the basketball and practicing with it all the time, that's what's going to make you better. And I think the more you have it in your hands, the more confidence you have.
Three to shoot. Hardaway hard drive, leaning, hanging. Yes! Yes. It's over!
Oh, my! Oh! Nice!
I think the guys that I admire most of all were three big names, Larry Bird, Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson. Guys, when you're growing up, that's all you emulate, especially Magic Johnson being a tall guard and myself being a tall guard and trying to do the same things that he did.
Whoa! You talk about shades of Magic Johnson. What a sensational pass!
I think with what they've added to the game as far as the flair and the showtime, then I could just put another step on to it by going in there and dunking on guys.
Now the Magic have a break. Here's Hardaway.
I think that every player on this level has an ultimate goal, and that's to get a ring. And I think that they'll do anything to get there.
Great players make great plays and come up big.
The only thing that you play for is a ring. The money and all of that can go out of the door, but the most prestigious thing is just the ring. And just to even think about having a chance to win a ring is a great feeling.
Now, let's go on the scene with Milwaukee's Ray Allen, who spent a busy offseason. He made his movie debut and also helped out his old neighborhood.
This is the first layup, guys.
Ray dedicated a new court in his hometown of Hartford, Connecticut, where he helps kids through his Ray of Hope Foundation.
Some guys might not want to be a role model, but I know kids, that's how they see professional athletes and professional people in general. So, you know, that puts me in a position where, you know, I'm in the community and, you know, everything I do is charity and, you know, it's given for the kids and it's something that I've been wanting to do for a long time. Keep it coming. Good layup. Ooh, that was Dr. J.
It means a lot to me to give back to the community. Hopefully, you know, I'm just the start of something good, the start of something great in this community.
Thanks, Ray!
Allen also teamed up with fellow Connecticut native Vin Baker of the Sonics for a charity game. They're a powerful pair when it comes to helping out in their home state.
I really think, you know, Ray and I are positive role models in the state of Connecticut, and I think it's important for us to come back here and do things positive, you know, come back and support every thing we can support.
Action! Ray also learned a new craft, acting. He was picked by film director Spike Lee to play Jesus Shuttleworth, a high school basketball star in the movie He Got Game.
Spike, you know, his seat is right where we warm up at halftime, and we came back in and, you know, he came up to me and he asked me would I audition for a movie of his. And I didn't know it would be all this and just major role playing Jesus. I just thought, you know, hey, cameo. Shout hallelujah. I just always said that I wanted to be on TV. I wanted to do TV, just act.
That was on ball, kid.
On ball? Nigga, you fouled me. That's the only thing gonna block my shot anyway.
You fouled me. Sipping all this wine.
Our mission was to find somebody in the NBA who also had some innate natural acting ability that they might not even know about. And, you know, it's not just doing a film. Ray Allen made a commitment this summer to this movie. And I don't think that He Got Game will be Ray Allen's last, you know, run before the camera. He is a promising career.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more of NBA Jam right after this.
Here's Michael at the foul line.
The Bulls win!
Johnson has it, and he throws it up.
This week, we share a memorable moment with Sacramento Kings rookie Olivier St. John.
One of the most unbelievable plays I've ever seen in this game. It's the dunk that Tom Chambers had on Mark Jackson.
Oakley smacking Chambers. Threw it away. 2-on-1. Chambers,
that was the nastiest dunk I've ever seen in my life. I mean, you have nasty dunks. Honestly, you can have nasty dunks. You know, Kevin Johnson over Akeem.
Oh, my!
Joining over a lot of people.
Look out!
And this was, it was unbelievable. And I know people that saw it happen live. As a basketball player, you experience it once in a lifetime. The time when you're gonna jump, and it's just your highest jump. And he kept on going up. My friends used to tell me, as he was going up, everybody would stand up because they knew it was a special moment. And even Mark Jackson admitted that it was the most craziest thing you've ever seen. It was unbelievable, really.
Today, we travel to Houston, Texas, where we join the Rockets' Matt Bullard for this week's NBA Tour.
Hi, I'm Matt Bullard of the Houston Rockets, and I'm going to take y'all on a trip around Houston.
Bullard with the fake, on the drive for two. Beautiful move by Dr. B.
Okay, everybody, welcome to Houston. You can see behind me, this is where we practice, the Houston Rockets practice facility. It's state-of-the-art, one of the best places in the NBA, in my opinion, and Houston is a great city. We're going to go out and show you some of the sights. Up there in the distance, you see that tall building, that's the Transco Tower, that's where we're headed. That's one great thing about Houston, it's so flat that never get lost, you can just get out of your car, get up on the bumper and look around, and you can see where you need to go. Here I am in front of the Transco Tower. We're getting ready to go inside. Come on, let's go. We gotta try to find the elevators. Hey, excuse me, sir. You know where the elevators are at?
Right around the corner.
Oh, thank you. Hey, I'm Matt Bullard. Are you a Houston Rockets fan?
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
Chris Blue.
Hey, Chris. Nice to meet you. Right. See, everyone in Houston is a huge Rockets fan. How you guys doing? Hey, guys. How you doing? Hey, big guy. Can I have five?
All right.
The medical center's over there. It's those two towers out there. Houston's got one of the largest medical centers in the country. You've got some great physicians here. However, I hope I never get to meet them. Here's the wall of water. Got a nice little park out here. One interesting fact about the wall of water is it recycles over 78,000 gallons of water every 3.5 hours. Now, don't ask me how I know that. I just do. Okay, everybody ready? We're going in. We might get a little wet, but I need a shower anyway. Kind of nice. You get in here and stand and look at it. You get kind of dizzy. Architects were actually from New York, if you can believe that. There it says 11,000 gallons of water per minute spill over the walls. Okay, here we are coming up on the summit. You see we got the Texas flags out in front. Texas is a great country, greatest country in the world. Okay, we're going into the bottom of the summit. This is the way the players go into the game. My favorite part about the summit is the championship banners up in the rafters. We've got the championship from 1993-94, which team I was on. Up there, and then also right next to it is the championship from 94-95, which I wasn't on, unfortunately. But got two championship banners in the rafters, and we want to try to get one more. Sir Charles, he needs a ring, so we're going to try to get him one. Well, that's the end of our tour. Hope you had a good time. I know I had a great time. Got to see where the Rockets practice, got to see the Transco Tower, the Wall of Water, and the summit where the Rockets play. Well, I got to go. See y'all later.
Coming up, even the world's greatest athletes can have a bad day. So watch out. Some NBA bloopers are coming right at you in our Jam of the Week. Also coming up,
no doubt,
we'll go all access with the Charlotte Hornets for a look at communication on the court.
Gotta shoot!
So we'll put on our game face and come back in just a moment. Jam of the Week, we'll check out last season's NBA bloopers. Here's OMC with How Bizarre.
Brother Pele's in the back, sweet singers in the front, cruising down the freeway in my hot, hot sun. Suddenly, we're blue lights, flash us from behind. Loud voice booming, please step out onto the line. Ballet bridge was a comfort, Cena just hides her eyes. Policeman taps the shades of Santa Chevy 69. How bizarre. How bizarre, how bizarre. Destination unknown, as we're calling for some gas. Officially placed a poster, reveals a smile from the pack. Elephants and acrobats, lion, snakes, monkey. Village beats righteous, Sister Cena says funky. How bizarre. How bizarre, how bizarre.
Stuck around TV news and cameras. There's choppers in the sky. Marines, police, reporters out there, far and wide. Billy yells, we're out of here. Cena says right on. Making moves and starting grooves before they knew we were gone. Jumped into the Chevy, ready for big lights. Wanna know the rest? Hey, by the rights. How bizarre. How bizarre. How bizarre.
Every time I look around, it's in my face.
When he rammed it into the side.
East baseball.
Every time I look around,
every time I look around, it's in my face.
NBA Jam will return in just a moment. One of the keys to success is communicating on the court. You'll see what we mean as we go all access with the Charlotte Hornets.
You over there, Dave, Dave!
Oh!
Force down, 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 down! Down, down!
Force down, Dave, force down, Dave!
Help! Hey, we gotta talk!
Talking is a very important thing, you know, in a Hornets basketball.
I got him! Go high! Watch Miller.
Oh, especially in defense, yeah. You gotta talk.
Go inside, Dave. Watch big down.
You have to talk, let people know that your teammates know where other guys are.
Watch behind you! Mate, where you at?
Especially the big guys have to talk to the little guys.
Watch back.
Behind you, Glenn, behind you.
Good talking, baby, good talking.
I think it gives your teammate a sense of someone having his back.
Hey, talk to me, let me know what you wanna do.
You gotta have everybody on the same page. And
early, go in, go.
If we can do those things, you know, get out there, talk, communicate, and do the little things, we're gonna be all right.
Flatten it out. Come up. Hey, Bobby, flip it up.
Our plays, guys, we don't have a bunch of them. Well, we got the turns and the floppy with the special, horns down, fist up.
It's step four.
We got the corner play, and then hurry is with Lonnie. You're taking the ball and throwing it over the top.
Great pass. Great pass, Lonnie.
Everybody keep supporting one another, talking.
Right there.
Money. Shoot it.
Booyah.
Good strong, baby. Good strong.
Yeah, that's my heat, man.
You know, just conversation out there on the court is a key to winning a lot of basketball games.
Nice shot.
Go get it, nice.
Mate.
Hell of a pass right there. Hell of a pass, Bobby. Good job.
What do you call it, baby? They can't stop them.
The more comfortable we become with one another, the much better team we're going to be.
That shot over there before, man, that's, you know, I mean, that's on a, there's nobody even close to the board.
Oh, it was 4-on-2, my bad.
Us two, them four. We're getting there. It's going to take a while, but everybody's pretty excited about the potential for us to, you know, have everybody playing and being in sync.
Be aggressive. See the ball. Come on, see the ball right now. Go.
Don't tell me you made it that fast. Yo, you're lucky.
Yo, if everything a man was right here.
You didn't see it. You guessed. Yes, you did. It was good. But you didn't see him.
That's our show for this week. Remember, you can email us with questions or comments at nba.com. See you next time, right here on NBA Jam.